Why you need a framework for a framework? If you are building applications with Vue.js, you have probably heard of Nuxt.js. Vue already makes the development of JavaScript applications more convenient. But what's the idea behind Nuxt.js? It's a progressive framework based on Vue.js. It simplifies the development of universal or single-page apps. And this video is all about what Nuxt.js in detail is, which features you are getting, and how you can create your first project. Finally, you get an overview of the files and folder structure. There are some differences to a regular Vue.js project. Nuxt is based on Vue.js official libraries. That means on Vue, the Vue router, Vuex, and also on powerful development tools like Webpack or Babel, for example. It extends Vue.js by some helpful features and only with a few extra kilobytes added to your JavaScript files. First, let's dive into the reasons why you might consider Nuxt for your next Vue.js project. Nuxt makes creating universal apps easier. What is a universal app? A universal app can execute on both the client and the server side. If you create a single page application with Vue.js, you have a lot of benefits. For example, you can make very snappy UIs that updates fast, but, and this is a problem, Google and other search engines struggle with them because there's no content initially on the page to crawl for SEO purposes. All the content is rendered with JavaScript after the fact. And with a universal app, you have instead of an index.html without content, a preloaded app on a web server that sends rendered HTML for every route to speed up load times and improve SEO by making it easier for search engines to crawl the page. The next benefit is, you can pre-render your app to a static website. That's in my opinion the most significant innovation. You can create with the command nuxt generate a completely static version of your application. It generates an HTML file for every route and you have all the benefits of a universal app. But the difference is that you don't need a web server anymore. Everything gets generated during the deployment period. It's mighty because you get the benefits of universal rendering without the need for a server. You can host your app on GitHub pages or a cloud service like Google Firebase. You could even host your website with Google Drive without paying a single coin. You are entirely free. There are many more benefits you have with Nuxt, but now it's time to create our first Nuxt.js project. I'm currently in Visual Studio Code. No file or project is open, just the terminal. You know, we can create a new project with Vue, create, and then the name. If you use the Vue CLI service. But if you want to create a Nuxt project, we have to use another tool, npx. The difference to npm is that npx is a tool to execute Node.js packages. Npm is only a manager for download and installing Node packages. And it's shipped by default since Node Package Manager in version 5, and you don't have to install it separately, but if you don't have it for some reason, you can install it with npm install minus g for globally and then npx. Well, let's create now a new project with npx. And there is a scaffolding tool you can use, created by the Nuxt team, create Nuxt app. And then you have to write a project name. Now it's downloading. That takes a few seconds or minutes, sometimes a long time based on your connection. Time for a coffee and some sandwiches, in my opinion. Okay, now we can change the project name if you want. I hit enter to keep the name. Now you can give a description here, but I'm sticking to the default. You can also change it later. Same with the next thing. Now you can choose your preferred language. I choose JavaScript. We want to use NPM, of course. Next, you have to choose a UI framework if you want. Bootstrap, Bulma, and so on. Framework? What the hell is framework? Well, I prefer to use the framework None. It's my favorite. Same for the server side. It's recommended, by the way. Next, you can choose additional modules if you need them, but we keep it simple and select nothing at first. Same for the linting tools, all optional. Choose a test framework, no. We are old school live tester. Generally, I recommend if you start with new things, keep it simple at first and catch up all the other stuff like test frameworks later when you are feel comfortable. The rendering mode universal is with server-side rendering and client-side navigation. Single-page app is only with client-side navigation. Universal is the default value and that's what I want to use. Next, you can choose the development tools. The first option is recommended if you use Visual Studio Code, so I select that with space and hit enter. Well, the magic stuff is running. And finally, you can switch to the new project folder and run it with npm run dev instead of serv. Keep that little difference in mind. But wait, do you remember that we were able to choose SCSS? No. If you still want to use it, you must install it separately at this time with npm install --save, and you need node sess and the sess loader. After that, you can use it just like you would with a Vue project. And now let's take a look at our new project. We have a bunch of folders and files, and let's go from top to bottom. First, we have here the assets folder. It's entirely the same as with you. You can store here all your static assets, your images for example, but also uncompiled SCSS files, which you are using in the whole application. Also, the components directory sounds familiar. The name suggests here is the place for all your components, for all. Not entirely, more in a few seconds. By the way, if you want to know how you can organize your components in the best way for better maintainability for all project sizes, I link the video in the description below. It's for a Vue project, but you can of course also use it for a Nuxt project. The layouts folder is new, and you have here already a file. Let's take a look. Okay, it's a Vue file and looks like a Vue file, but you see here is a Nuxt tag. It's a component provided by Nuxt, which renders the current route of your application. You can compare it to the router view component. It's a fantastic pattern in my opinion, because you can use more than one layout. For example, if you have a blog besides your main website, you can create for each part of your site different designs based on these layout files here. Or you can also have distinct layouts for mobile and desktop. It's a powerful pattern. It's also the place where you can put in the main navigation, a sidebar or the footer, entirely components which are used by all routes of your application. Next, we have here the middleware folder. Middlewares lets you define custom functions that can be run before, rendering a page or a group of pages. Also importantly, the middleware has access to the context, which provides additional objects and params from your application. You have here also access to the Vuex store and the ViewRouter. That's amazing. You can create a navigation guard where you can check an authentication status before the requested route is delivered. Another example would be that you could evaluate the user agent here and using a different layout depending on the case. You can do here a lot of great stuff, very powerful. The pages directory contains your application views and routes. Nuxt reads all the .view files inside this directory and creates the application router automatically. And Nuxt provides for each component a bunch of additional attributes you can use. For example, which layout you want to use, if you have some. Or you can also use here the head attribute to define a custom title, description or meta tags for this page and so on. Nuxt uses here the plugin ViewMeta for the head attribute, which is also available for a regular Vue.js project. The plugin folder is the place where you can set up additional libraries like FontAwesome for example, but you can also create your reusable pieces of JavaScript code to register components globally, and to inject functions or constants could also be a possibility. The static directory is directly mapped to the root folder from your application, so that's the place for your robot or sitemap files and so on. The store directory contains your Vuex store files and comes with Nuxt.js out of the box but is disabled by default. Creating a JavaScript file in this directory enables the store. Nuxt.js lets you decide between two store modes at this time. The first one is with the index.js file, the classic way, which is also deprecated. So I recommend using the second mode with unique names like todo.js or block.js, which gets transferred to the Vuex namespace modules. The Nuxt config file is also interesting. You can change the mode from universal to single page application and back. You are entirely free to change that on any time. But keep in mind, if you are using the SPA mode, you can't use server-side rendering or any other special server handling. On the other hand, in combination with the generate feature, it gives you a powerful deployment mechanism. Furthermore, you have here the default setup from the page head, which you can customize. Nuxt gives you out of the box a loading process bar component that's shown between routes. You can customize it, disable it or create your own. Excellent feature in my opinion. And below you can register additional global CSS files, plugins and modules. Furthermore, you can extend the Webpack configuration. The whole thing sounds quite logical structured in the end. You have probably already noticed that we don't have here a main.js file or an app root component, right? Well, you don't need it. Each component in the pages directory is basically a root component from a specific route, and the fantastic thing is, you can for each route set up a different layout if you want. Additional libraries and other JavaScript pieces to register global components and other stuff can you set up as a plugin. To me, it all seems well organized and tidy. Now, it's your turn. Create your first Nuxt project today and play around with the new possibilities. Thank you so much for watching. I see you in the next video.